The night the fighting broke out, I had no idea it would, like anybody else. It's not by choice that I left South Sudan. I was living in Juba. It wasn't by choice that I left. I still wish I could be there. Now here I am in Kampala with no job, no hope of returning to South Sudan any soon, with a family to look after.
لمدة ثلاثة أيام في فندق جريز هاوس بنيروبي ابتدأنا ورشة إنتاج صحيفة خاصة بمشروع النيلان. جمعت عدد من الصحفيين والصحفيات، وكانت تجربة لإنتاج هذه الصحيفة تجربة أنا في اعتقادي تجربة فيها الكثير من التحدي والكثير من المقامرة والكثير من الشغف لإنتاج مادة صحفية.
We've had a series of workshops here in Nairobi, and this is the latest one. And this time round, we're trying something new, and that is to produce a print edition during this number of 3 or 6 days, involving all the journalists in the production, and a small number will stay longer and actually help edit and lay out this new edition, the 7th edition of the Nairobi. Did an edition, People on the Move, which looked into this issue already, but this is particularly relevant right now as it's a pressing issue in both countries. And we also, the idea was sparked also from us being based in Germany, where the refugee issue is extremely crucial. So it's relevant from both sides of the story.
وجد حيز كبير في كل وسائل الإعلام وأصبح قضية العالم، لأنه سيحدث تغيرات كبيرة جدا قد تكون بعد 10-15 عام، لأنه مؤكد أنه الهجرة بتحدث أيضا تغيرات اجتماعية في المجتمعات المضيفة، ولها أيضا يتأثر المهاجر بالثقافة التي ذهب إليها ويؤثر بدوره في الثقافة. هذا يعني أننا يعني نناقش قضية مهمة، نتوقع من قادة العالم المفكرين أن يأتونا بحلول.
Unlike in the past, where we have been sending our articles to the editors in Berlin, but this time is that we have been doing the work ourselves. With the guidance of the editors, we generate the material from all the team members, the content. We even make dummy pages of how the layout will be. We have been empowered to take charge of producing the paper.
أعتقد القصص التي نشرت أو التي كتبت كانت قصص جميلة ومبتكرة ومتنوعة ومثيرة في أحيان كثيرة، تحكي قصص إنسانية، فكرة الهجرة من وطن إلى آخر أو الرجوع إليه، أو فكرة إنسان معين قرر الهجرة بطريقة غير شرعية، أو صحفية واجهت مشاكل في الوطن ومشاكل من الشرطة والأجهزة الأمنية وقررت أن تهاجر وتترك أسرتها. التجربة أضافت لي أنه أنا أشتغل مع حوالي 10 صحفيين من الشمال والجنوب حول قضية واحدة أو قضية واحدة، لكن ننظر إليها من زوايا متعددة وجهة نظر مختلفة، لكنها في النهاية تصب في قضية واحدة، قضية إنسانية، هي الهجرة وتداعياتها وإفرازها.
My group with my co-editor, Mr. Hassan. I am from English background, he is from Arabic background. Some of the guys Hassan works with from Arabic background, and mine are from English background. So sometimes communication, there is a big gap in understanding some of the issues. Though later on we are able to put things together with the help of people who know both English and Arabic.
Hassan and Wakir are going to talk about pages 5 and 6.
I'm the newest member on the team, and I'm working as a language assistant slash editor for this edition of the newspaper. It's particularly interesting for a few reasons. Number one being that people's stories are very rich, very in depth, and getting to know people and then later working on their stories was a quite fulfilling experience, enjoyable. and didn't feel like work at all.
What is that thing?
This is like a very diverse group of people. Guys from Germany, you from Morocco, some from Sudan, and others from South Sudan and Uganda as well. So it was a really nice experience mixing cultures and getting to know different people. And then, actually, I think I've found another love for journalism now, photojournalism. I have really, really enjoyed the experience of doing it here, and I think I'm going to take it up more.
صفحة 5 كان فيها كولاج وهو كان حاجة جديدة لأول مرة تتعمل. التمرين كان جميل جدا فاني وحاولنا بقدر الإمكان إنه نوصل عبر الكولاج الفكرة الأساسية اللي تتعمل عليها النسخة الجاية من الميزان. وأنا أفتكر إنه دي الميزة بتاعت الورشة دي اللي هي العمل الجماعي. هي دي الميزة يعني لأول مرة إحنا في الميزان نشتغل المجلة بالشكل الجماعي ده.
I am able to understand how challenging also, you know, editors go through, especially working on stories of reporters. It also put me into a position on how to interact in that way, you know, to really induce or push somebody to come up with a content or something that you think is missing in the story.
We have had a lot to learn, and I believe with the knowledge we have acquired throughout this exercise will even make us better to produce more issues, inshallah.
أقوى من قول العوازل واسمى من كلمة وشاية. السنين اللي عشت فيها معاك هنايا أقوى من قول العوازل واسمى من